to people, right?
The Minister of Transport, General Edward Katumba Wamala, has disclosed that ever since the closure of the Khartoum airspace due to the conflict in Sudan, Uganda airspace is facing heavy traffic.
And that our airspace is not going to enlarge. It's the same space we have today. It's possibly the same space we shall have ever after. So we must optimally use it to be able to facilitate whoever wants to use it in a legal way.
This tempted the government to learn new strategies to ensure that the airspace is very safe to avoid ugly scenarios that might happen in the air.
That you cannot, for example, deny airline X using your airspace in case of an emergency, for example, or to do an overflight, as that case has happened when some of the airspaces have been closed, which they used to use.
The minister made the remarks today during the inauguration of a civil military aviation policy board in Kampala. The board, which constitutes officers from the Uganda People's Defense Forces, has been tasked to establish the three committees it is supposed to work hand in hand with to ensure air safety.
It shall monitor and coordinate civil and military aviation activities, provide policy direction, allocate resources, and ensure the state's high-level aviation policies and strategies are implemented in accordance with international civil aviation organization standards and recommended practices.
The inauguration of the board comes at a time when the International Civil Aviation Organization is to soon audit Uganda's aviation industry on conformity to aviation safety standards.
So it's important that we make our airspace very, very safe, very safe. Because while we can afford to have, some encouraging accidents on the road, but the accidents in the air are more devastating.
The International Civil Aviation Organization is responsible for ensuring that the skies are safe, and during the audit, they will carry out the continuous monitoring approach and universal security oversight.
Reduce flight times and efficiency of flight operations. This will ultimately make Uganda airspace more attractive to operators.
The Director General of the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority, Fred Bamwesije, observed that the audit is key in shaping the future of the country's aviation industry, and it should be taken seriously by all players.
Somewhere to start during the day as a civil operation, and then by evening it is a military operation. Same operation. And our challenges have been that this directorate and this level of discussion and coordination has not been able to manage such situations.
Statistics recently put out by the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority indicated that there is an increase in the number of passengers registered at the Entebbe International Airport since the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic. Story compiled by Jeliet Namuwaya and Peace Navuga for the news.